to allocate fiber assignments using Excel LBA. First thing that you do, you press reset. Everything disappears. This is where the terminal is going to be located. It could be pole front, pole side, wall, pedestal, GLB, put whatever. But most of this design is area, so we're going to put pole front as default. And most of it is pre-stub design. And here you put the FDSA number. After you've added this detail, you just click run. So this is how it's populating the Excel with the correct information, terminal information. So instead of manually typing all this information, it's we will get this this information will come from the Excel direct to the stencil. So once you come up with the design overview and cable layout of where all the cables are going to be placed, either in poles or in ducts, you draw where the terminals are supposed to be placed, and so we start allocating the fiber counts from the farthest. So this is the farthest from the CSP. You can see our CSP is right here, and then this cable is right here. So you start allocating accordingly. So this is going to be PA. So PA is pole opposite 14. So you come here, change this, you drop it down, and put P opposite 14. And which address? Princess Street. So normally I like copying and pasting, because you don't make typos when you do that. So similar here, it's opposite 28, Princess Street 2. You see, you drag it down, so you avoid repetition. So all these terminals are how many terminals? Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All those terminals are now Fullerton. But before we continue, this cable has 48, right? Has reserved counts here. 20 has reserved counts here, because you can see 48. So in our project, so it only goes to 24, but it has to go to 48. So this is how you resolve. So you come here and just place 24, because there's 24 resolved fibers there. When you place here, it will ask you, and then it will create counts 25, 24. These are going to be your reserved counts. You drop it here and say reserved at the splice. No, you could say spares in the splice. And then here you say in, and then you the splice is at 14, right? Princess, you see how easy this is. And then your last count here, the last row in that here, you see our last row is 48. You just click here and the number, click 1 to create a cable. You see the cable is already cam 5 RT. So this is 144 48, just like here, 48, and you and counts on this cable are from 1 to 48, and that's cable S. You put the labels there, S, and then this was PA, PB. See how easy it is to assign counts? And then all these terminals are on Fullerton, so you will grab this, copy this, copy, paste it here, and drag it. There's a lot of terminals on Fullerton. You start with 72, right? This terminal PC 72. Front of 64, and then 56, and then 56 again. There's two terminals at 56. You have to put a number sign on them because number sign on one, second one to be finished yet for the past one. Two. You see that? Those are finished. And then you're gonna. And then there's a, this cable going here. It's 24. So come here. Put 24 here. And then you click here. So once you finish populating the Excel with the correct information, you go to Visio, and then you go data custom, you go next, and you browse where you save the Excel, and you go and then and you open it, you go down and select input and then custom range, then it will open this. It will open this, and then you will select from box to LB. LB means the label, and then you select all the information that you entered here, and then you click OK, and you go next, turn off some of these, you don't need them, go next, and then you select unique ID, and then you finish. So all the data is already here. And then here, you just grab one of these. These already stencils already programmed with to read this data from Excel. So you just go here, data link, click all shapes, and then you drop it down to ID and then both sides. And then click next, and then say finish. So you could actually see this terminal. The terminals are automatically linked to the data with the same ID. They already linked to the data, and then they already also added your cable length here. So you just say ungroup, and then you place the terminals where they're supposed to be, right? By you doing this way, it's minimizing, reducing the amount of typos that you're gonna have, because all this data was copy and paste, and it's accurate. You could actually see. Right, 28 right there. You just drag those labels to where they're supposed to go. And then the design is finished in like 1 hour instead of imagine typing all these all for like 100 terminals. How long do you think you're gonna do this work? How long do you think it's gonna take you to finish it? Long time. But when you do it, when you do it like this, it's much easier, and then you have like a centralized point where you can control information, which is really valuable. Yeah, it's really valuable. You see this? Copy. Come on and make me feel so free. I am worse. So you see? Those are all centralized points. So you could easily go back here and make some edits. Like if you feel like these things are not good enough, you could maybe make this 150, right? And then maybe you don't want this length here, put the XX. Yeah, maybe you don't need this length here too. These ones. The magic behind this is you could save this and then go back to your Visio and then just go here and say refresh. Now watch what's happening to these two terminals. You see XXX? So you could control all data here in the Visio over there in Excel. Now imagine if you had a revision, it would take you really less time to do that revision because you already have a centralized point where data is being controlled. You don't have to type this physically. Take time.